otherwise. So mnajua lazima to dance kamoja, eh? Gotcha. Guess who's back? Guess who's back? Otherwise. Guess who's back? Guess who's back? Today is a pajamas kind of day because it's my off day. Hello, nimeshinda tu usafi, kufua, ku vacuum, ku chill. Sasa ndio ku change bedding. Mkojo. Mimi niko fit. Leo ni off day. Nikasema nichilete hapa. Si mnajua ni lazima nikuje niwabariki na culture shock ingine. So I think this is culture shock part 4. And we are just redoing this, especially because now we have more subscribers. Initially, I had done this series of culture shock, but we were around 70 subbies. But now we are 923, okay? Biscuit, excuse me. Excuse me, Biscuit. Excuse me. Sit down. Sit down. Excuse me. Biscuit, whatever I'm eating here, you can't eat. This has onion and this one has a chocolate. Okay? Okay? Anyway. Barabara kabisa, tuende sako kwa bako, hadi kwa mataratara. Yeah, culture shock part 4. Okay? Wala waja watch, muende muwatch part 1, part 2, part 3. Na pia, the new subscribers, muende muangalie hizo series nilikuwa nimefanya when I was very new. In the land of King Charlie. Alrighty who? Okay, so let's go. So, culture shock ya leo number 1. Ni summer bunnies kutoeng. Iyo inakuanga ni kitu ambayo inatatanisha wa Kenya sana. Some take it like it's pride. Others taking like ni kama mtu anajifanya amefika. Juu sasa amekuja nyumbani with that swang. Anywho, now that I'm here, I've come to learn. Okay, I'm not saying everyone. Mi najiongelelea mimi. Because, of course, kuna wale watatwang because they want to just change. But mina jongelelea mimi. When I came here, I realized the locals here don't quite get some things we see. So, maybe, for example, unasema a certain word. Then the local tells you, say that again, love. Say that again, love. I didn't get you. So, unarudia. Ukijirudia, excuse me, ukijirudia that same word, you try now to make it as refined as you can so that you can communicate. Biscuit, excuse me, stop, that's a chocolate. You can't eat a chocolate, Biscuit. I'm sorry. You already had your snack, you had your meal. Please, sit down. Excuse me. Anyway, sorry about that. So when the local tells you, what do they say? Say that again, love. When you're repeating yourself, you find yourself repeating that same word in a very refined way to the best of your ability. To make it as refined as you can so that uwe mwenye mnaongea naye askie nini unasema. So, more often than not, you'll find yourself repeating some phrases, some words. And na vile tu naendelea kurudia hizo words, you find yourself, the next time you say it like them. And within no time, you find that unaanza kuongea kama hao. And that's how twang inaingianga. Okay? Lakini mimi ningetaka sana kutwang. Ni vile hii ya huku ni ngumu. Kutwang ya huku ni ngumu kuzi ni kumeza tea. Kumeza tea. Boa. What else do they say? They say boa. They say, nini ingine ikona tea? Wanamezanga tea. Anywho. So twanging may happen without someone even realizing, especially because the locals mostly they don't hear what you're saying. Wanasemanga, we actually, they say we speak so fast. Wengine wanasema our pronunciation, it's very heavy for them, so we have to do, you know, sisi nyumbani ni sisi tunasemanga wanaongeanga fast, but now huku wanasemanga tunaongea fast. Anyway, so that's how you find yourself twanging, really. If you repeat one word or one phrase more often than not, the next time you say it, you'll try to say it like the time you were told to repeat, and you try to pronounce it to the best of your ability, as refined as you can, and eventually utaanza kupata lingo yako ina change. Lingo yako ina change. Most might not change mara moja boof, but it a change, and that's how you find yourself twanging. So really, twanging, mtu akichange, it's not cause unaringa. Okay, mimi najiongelelea mimi. Hata sina kitu ya kuringia anyway. Bado. So that's my point on twanging. So that's the culture shock of watu nyumbani kufikiria mtu juu amekuja majuu, akirudi nyumbani ana twang juu anaringa. Not necessarily. Let's go to number two. Culture shock number two. When I came here, I realized like almost everyone has an iPhone. Almost everyone has the most recent iPhone. Uku iPhone, hey. Nyumbani mtu akipata iPhone ni mtu akona kakiro. You know what I'm saying? Uku kila mtu akona iPhone. Mimi ilikuwa culture shock for me. Because, like, kila mtu iPhone. Kila mtu hapa anatumia Apple. Like, majority of the guys here use Apple. But, bako watu wenye anatumia Apple ni watu wako na kakiru. Ama maybe somebody bought a reconditioned one. Ama mtu amepassiwa on by someone. Like, maybe, for example, me, simu yangu ni decide to pass on to someone. Someone, maybe back home, nimwambia, by the way, are you interested in this? Then nimpatie. Then I get myself a new one or whatever. Yeah, like that. So that was a culture shock for me. And then when I came, me, sinilikuja na Oppo. Muna kumbuka vile Oppo ilikuanga Slay Queen. Nairobi. Kwanza me, the office I used to work with, like, everyone used to have an Oppo. Alafu watu walikuwa najisikia na Oppo. Ilikuanga inaitonga je hiyo charger, type C. Sisi tukitafuta a small pin, watu wakona, I don't have a small pin, I have type C. So, Oppo ilikuanga, ilikuanga Slay Queen. Where? So, kukuja huku, mdosi wangu akaniuliza, what type of phone is that? Then I said, it's an Oppo. A what? I said, Oppo. She told me, oh, you gotta get yourself a new phone, you know. You gotta just... Gai, midilishanga zileza. Na hiyo Oppo yangu na nimpia nimenunua nikikuja maju. Mdosi haitambui. Karibu nimwambia, hiyo Oppo yetu kwetu nyumbani, Oppo inakuanga Slay Queen. Inakuanga Oppo, Apple. Oppo, Apple. Anyway, that's culture shock number two. Like, realizing that everyone here uses an iPhone. Yo niliona ikiwa, okay. Kuni inji ingine. Let's go. Leo, by the way, niko na mpaka notes. Leo hii video itakuwa refu na sijali, okay? Because nataka kumaliza history ya culture shock. Then we can talk about something else. So, another culture shock is the fact that almost everyone in this country has a car. Hapa ku drive gari, it's absolutely nothing. It's normal. Ni kawaida. Owning a car here or driving a car here, it's like you having a cell phone. It's like you having a biro pen. Driving here, it's nothing to raise eyebrows. Nyumbani, culture shock here is back home, all those guys who drive, it actually says something about them in terms of status, or do I say status, in the community. If anybody has a car, anaangaliwa in a certain level in terms of status in the society. Back home, having a car is a big deal. Actually, it's an achievement. It's actually an achievement. Like, even some of us will go to work hard to get a car and a house and whatever, you know. Like, working towards getting a car back home was a big deal. Everybody drives. I'm telling you, everybody drives because a car here is a necessity. And that's why you find at our to your high school, by the time anamaliza, akifika 215, ananza kutrainiwa. Ananza kudrive na ile L. L means lazima drive ukiwa na mtu amekuwa na British driving license for over 3 years. So muna drive na mtu, ukiwa na core driver hapo. By 15, washaanza kulearn. So that by 16, they get their permit. It's nothing to raise eyebrows about having a car here. Everybody has a car. And then guess what? Back home, nilikuwa naona, wale wako na magazlas. You know, like you find someone with a Beamer, somebody with a Mercedes, somebody with a Range. Those are people who actually, yani watu wame make it. You know, darling, do you know hapa? Ata sisi watu wenye wakibaru. You can find someone with a BMW, Audi, even a Range. You can find a janitor driving a Range. Naongelelea mtu wa kuosha. A cleaner can be driving a Tesla. Oh, my dear. Mtu wa salon. Unamkuta ako na Range. So huku, having a car doesn't... It's absolutely nothing to raise eyebrows about. Because I mean, the culture here is anybody can afford a car. Even a brand new one. You know, gari mpya karatasi hapa mtu anaweza pata. But back home, ni wapi utakuta mtu wa salon ama mtu wa kuosha ama even a teacher akiafford gari kama Tesla. You know what I mean? I'm saying culture shock. Hapa, utakuta mtu ameenda amekuja kwa nyumba ya mtu, anamfanyia nini haircut na hapo nje amepark Tesla. Me, that was a culture shock for me. Huh? Okay. I love for another thing. What do I want to say? Kwa nini zinapotea potea? Leo, by the way, video itakuwa refu. Okay. Leo, tunakula msene mpaka tumalize. Msene. A culture shock. Back home, ukipata gazla, unajua huyu, it's either a very rich politician, a business mogul, yani ni mtu mdosi. Ni watu wa dosi. Ni ma dynasty. Ima naitangwaji. You know, mtu wa biashara mbinya kuna ma millions. Ni anafford those big cars. Hapa, don't always assume that kukiona gari kubwa, we assume ati, hey, we ni president. It could be hata watu wa kibaru kama mimi. Unaweza kuta mtu wa kibaru kama mimi ako na hiyo gari. Okay, of course isemi mimi. By the way, me I'm a small farmer in here. But even me being a small farmer, I've bought now how many cars? 3. Hata hii nina exchange August. I don't know why I'm laughing. Like, that's why I'm saying here, gari, it's easy to get. It's easy to get. That's my point. Back home, hey, nachukua gari moja na ilipia your loan 5 years. 5 years? Then before you think of exchanging, 10 years zimeenda. Na hiyo gari yenye umenunua, ni second hand, lakini iko na number plate mpya. Hapa, let me tell you guys. If your credit score agrees, unaweza nunua hata gari ya karatasi. Tafakari yao. And by the way, so far gari zetu si tumebuy ni cash. But new immigrants, gari mnanunua cash. Unless kama umefikisha 2+ years, that's when you can actually get, you can now start negotiating in terms of getting a brand new car, because you, of course, wezi lipa cash. Brand new cars, unajua lazima ukofa some money and you utalipa maybe with a plan. Anyway, now I'm going out of topic. Anyway, all I'm saying is driving a car here or having a big car doesn't necessarily say at you what you are, you're posh in the society. Come back home. People who drive big cars back home are actually posh. And anybody who can afford a car back home is actually considered to be not doing so badly off. That's my point. Hapa kila mtu drive gari. Usi, utakuta social classes up as you go so clearly defined come back home. Back home social classes are well defined, sadly. That's not a compliment. Utakuta kuna wale wenye hawaezi hata make to, there are people who are not even making a meal in a day. Yeah. And munajua kwenye the kind of places where they live. And then utakuta kuna wale average, maybe like people who go to work, watu wenye wanaendanga job, watu wanalipangwa, au watu wanaendanga job ya 8 to 5. Au, I mean, in the society wanakonsideriwa average back home. Well, average ya huku, my friend. Ni posh. Anyway, what I'm saying is, social classes are very well defined back home. Hapa social classes, not so much. You might not quite tell by looking at someone whether ako na doa mahana. Unaweza kuta mtu hata amekaa tu normal. You can be riding on a bus with a millionaire. Mumekaa hapo kwa bus na yeye na uwezi jua. Lakini back home, mtu mwenye ako na doa, yani hata aingie bus gani? Yake no. You know what I mean? Yeah. Nina feel ni kama nina explain sana. Then again, hata huku estate zetu naishi, ziko tu sawa. Of course, kuna we have the very, very posh people in the society. Na uta notice the places where they live. But more or less, hakuna hiyo big difference kama home whereby unajua, maybe there are people who are living in Madare, there are people who are living in what's it called? You know, in the slum area, there are people who are living in places kama kina Sukari, places kama, what's it called? Kuna watu wanaishi Muthaiga, you know, kuna watu wanaishi Karen, you know what I mean? They're very well defined. Hapa, awezi angalia estate ati useme, ile estate ndio inakuanga watu wa posh, na ile estate ndio inakuanga watu wa... Yes, we have such, but it's not like glaring in the eye. It's not like so open for you to just say, oh, your section inakuanga ya, na ile section inakuanga ya. Back home, you can clearly say, leafy suburbs in Zawadosi. We also have slum areas, and we have the other estates ziko hapo katikati. Kuna Gedurai, kuna Wapi, kuna Kariobangi. We have, you know what I mean? Kuna Kabete, kuna... You can clearly say, this estate is for this level. Kilimani is for this level. Kileleshwa is for this level. Keno is for this level. Karen is for that level. Kawangware is for that. You can clearly say, because it's glaring to the eye. That's what I'm saying. Apa, it's not clearly defined, and you just assume that estate is just for that. Because you can find a surgeon living next to a cleaner. Na wanaendelea na maisha vizuri sana, because so, the government here ime make it such a way. People are able to afford things. The basic things here may not necessarily be basic things back home. The basic things hapa, back home inaweza kuwa ni posh things, quote unquote. Anyway, enough topic about that. Let's move on. Appointments za GP. Sasa, unakumbuka kulikuwa na time, an expose done. I don't know ilikuanga TV station gani back home about the waiting time ukiwa na appointment, okay, rather not appointment, ukienda hosi, ukiketi in certain hospitals, how long you stay before you see a doctor within the waiting room. Wengine unakuta unakaa 6 to 8 hours in the waiting room. I know what I'm talking about because I've been a victim. Unaenda hosi, nikienda hosi Kenya nilikuwa naitisha like a whole day. Because sijui kama siwezi enda niambie mdosi ati, oh, ni allow ni rush one hour hosi, then I'll come back to work. Utaenda ukai ya waiting area for 6 hours. By time unaenda kuona daktari, umekaa hapo the whole day. So like kama ni kuenda hosi, una plan tu siku mzima. I know what I'm talking about because it's out of experience. Now, GP appointments hapa. GP akikwambia kuna appointment next week, Monday at 9 a.m. Be there. 5 minutes to 9. Because exactly 9 a.m. utaitwa. Na unamaliziwa faster. It's walk-in, walk-out. Kama ni blood test, unafanyua pa, pa, pa. Atakuwa shakwambia. Na utakumbushwa. utakumbushwa na text, remember you have an appointment on this and this with a GP surgery, and please bring this. If they need you to have a mask, they'll ask for it, but hardly do they ask here uko tulizangu mask. If they want you to do 1, 2, 3, like maybe for example, if they want to take sample of urine, watakwambia this and this, this is what you need to do to prepare before you come, blah 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 blah. That's what I'm talking about. So if it's 9, I can actually tell my boss, please ni allow like 1 hour on Monday morning, nikimbia hosi alafu nirudi job 10. You can actually do that here because ni walk in walk out. Nyumbani itabaki umepanga siku, ni kama siku ya kwenda donyo. Utakaa huko kwa hiyo hospitali. Sitaki kumention names mimi. No, like you can actually, you can find yourself spending the whole day there. Waiting room. Before atawane wewe daktari. Na hata si daktari unaenda kuona. Unaenda kuona clinical officer. I said it. Hapa kama ni GP, ni GP. Na kama GP ataona you need to go see a specialist, utatuma kwa specialist. Na kama ni specialist, ni specialist. Anywho, of course, back home nayo, hardly do we have like standard way of appointments, horsey. Standard, it's just walking. Like most of the time, it's just a walk-in, walk-out. Kama asubuhi ukiamka usikia, you feel fiti, una walk-in, horsey, na unatoka. Darling, nayo hapa, yeah. Appointments, zinakuanga in terms of emergency. Excuse me. In terms of urgency, unaweza kuwa maybe unaenda routine checkup na it's not an emergency, unaweza kuwa kwa list appointment yako inaweza putumwa, inaweza kuwa unaweza pata appointment unapewa 6-8 months from today. Kama si emergency, but then again I normally see kama ni emergency they'll utapata appointment like in 2 weeks. You know, if it's an emergency, unaweza kuta appointment imekwa like in 2 weeks. So that now wende wangaliwa rakaraka. But kama si emergency, darling, waiting list wanga kubwa sana huku. Unaweza kuta umengojea hata 6 to 8 months before pati appointment. Another culture shock. And pleasantly so. I realized here, ukienda kuhusi. I'll give an example. You remember that video niliwafanyia like I had an issue going on with my gum? Let me tell you, I was discharged after an year. Si nilifanyiwa 2 surgeries. Yeah. I was discharged officially after 1 year. In that 1 year, nilikuwa nimefanyiwa so many scans. Nilikuwa nilifanyiwa autopsy 2. What am I saying? They investigate. They proper investigate. They get to the root cause of that issue before ukwe discharged. And darling, before I could discharge, umepona. See, ati sasa ati nimeenda hosi, nimemaliziwa the last one, nimestichiwa, nimereleziwa, ati waniambia, oh, you've been discharged. No. Nimestichiwa, ni wamenifanya surgery ya pili, wakandistich, then I healed. They gave me a couple of months to heal. Then they rang me when I've healed to ask me how I'm doing, kama nimepona, blah, blah, blah. If I have any concern, if I need to be seen again, if... Before discharge iwe ukuwa umepona. Mi naongelelea experience yangu. Of course, kuna wale wakona experience different, but I can only speak for myself. You know what I'm saying? So, hiyo ni kitu ilinifurahisha. Like, hapa before wakupa, before upatiwe treatment ya kitu hapa, wamefanya investigation tests, thorough tests, scans, everything. Darling, utaenda kwa GP mara kadhaa. Na GP akiona unahitaji kuenda kwa specialist, atakutuma. Utaenda kwa consultant. Before they get to treat you and give you medication, wamefanya thorough investigation. Back home, sorry to say, nilikuwa naona sometimes unaenda hosi, ni kama kuna standard way. Oh, ukienda ukisema, oh, I'm having a tummy ache. Unapewa sijui ilikuanga nini. Nini watu walikuwa napewa kila time. Sijui umeambua kuna blood poisoning. Sijui. Na saizo hata maybe hata... Anyway, sijui umeenda umepewa ukaambiwa uko na amoeba. Sijui ume hii nyingine ilikuanga nini yenye kila mtu alikuwa anapewa dawa yake. Ilikuanga nini hiyo? What was that? Why am I forgetting that? I hope I remember it before we finish the video. What was that? asikumbuki, something to do with the tummy. Unaenda tu unapewa dawa na hata saizo hata uja, umesema tu nasikia hivi, nasikia hivi. Imagine unaenda unapatiwa prescription by vile una feel. Na sayo umesema ni tummy, na hata waja kufanyia hata stool. I'm not saying all the time, but majority of the time, you can be treated without a thorough investigation back home. Anyway, guy, aki leo kuko cloudy nje. I hope video itakuwa dark, sababu sijawasha hii light main. Hii light main wanga too glary. So, moving on. Quality control on goods and services. Darling, hapa ukibai kitu, you can return it. Ukifili yo kitu haiko to the satisfactory standards of what they wrote that thing will do. Ata wanakuanga wameandika hapo, you can return. Nyumbani, utenda uuziwe kitu fake. Uuziwe kitu, kama ninguo umenunua, umenda kufua, imetoa rangi yote. Now you have no one to cry for. Utaifanya tu mop. Utabangi tu umeifanya mop. Eh, hapa darling. Ukinunua kitu na ufeel haiko sawa, they tell you, you can return. You can return. Hey, I love another thing. Let's say, for example, you paid for a service and you feel that it was not up to date. Darling, ukienda tu upeane feedback kuseme you are not satisfied, utafanyiwa refund. No fights, no question asked. Refund, pap. Nyumbani nani anaku refund? Utaenda huko ushukwe nywele, utoke huko unakaa hivi. Hivi. Madhundo zinatokea huko ni vile umeshikwa nywele hivi and nobody cares. Utalala usiku umekaa hivi. You paid for that service, you're in pain, you're not happy, and nobody cares. And actually people just take that sadly back home people take, I think we back home culture yetu imetu fanya in a way, you just let me just use this word anyway, I'm just gonna use it. It's like our culture normalizes mediocrity, sorry to say. Out here, quality control, darling. Like, umenda restaurant, umekula, umekua msik. What? That's a problem. At umenda place, umenda restaurant, umekula meals, then you got sick. Then you report. That's a problem for that restaurant. For real. Umenda umenunua. Say, for example, nimenunua maybe a gadget. Nimekuja nayo, nimeitumia, ime break down within a week. Returning, darling. Unarudisha. Kuna mbaka poku umeambiwa unaweza rudisha tu, no questions asked. Nyumbani unarudishia nani? Tabaki tu umetupa kwa mbolea ama uweke hapo ikue nini reminder of the money you wasted. That's a culture shock for me. Now, hapa hakunanga discrimination. This is, for example, I've not finished the sentence, let me finish. In this country, they really really shun, they look down upon discrimination. Especially kama unaenda job ama unafanya anything, even in the society, you are absolutely not discriminated in terms of your sex, your race, your religion, your physicality. You are absolutely not discriminated. And if you get discriminated and you report, that's a problem for the person who discriminated upon you. That's a problem. Anyway, like now, there's a time my person was applying for a job, a really nice job, bado tunangojea feedback. Okay, anyway, let me just give that example. A really nice job, and guess what? In the application, they have a policy. Do not tell us where you're from. Do not tell us your race. Do not give any information that will make us know where you come from. No. Don't tell us you come from which country, we don't want to know. Don't tell us whether you're married or single, we don't want to know. Don't tell us your race. So the application is very, in terms of profile, they are just looking for your skill and they will test you. Utafanya aptitude, utafanya exams, yeah? And then you go from stage to stage to stage to stage. But how, darling, they don't want to know kama whether you're male or female. Hata ukiandika jina yako hapo, just, they don't care. But wanakuambia strictly, usituandikia date of birth, usituandikia country of origin, usituandikia, we don't, if you do that actually, that's ground for you to be discontinued. Like, if you're going to be picked for that job, they pick you because you have the skill. Nani job ya gava, by the way. Back home, unaenda unaandikiwa kakaratasi hivyo, kanota hapo na pencil, unafungiwa hivyo, unaambiwa patia soja kwa gate. So ukifika, hata before ingia hiyo gava office, soja kama hakujui na kama haujam, hawezi pita hiyo gate. Like, you have to be knowing someone who knows someone, who's gonna refer you to go see someone. So that you can get a job. And that's why we have so much, I mean, lack of professionalism, because most people who are in those, most people who are in positions back home are really incompetent. And I know what I'm talking about, because I've worked somewhere. And I used to see a lot of incompetence, but I cannot say anything about it, because uku ni kwa uncle, uku ni kwa auntie, ule nani, ule nanini, ule. You know what I'm saying? Hapa job yako, your skill. Your skill is what sells you. Nobody cares. Nobody wants. You don't have to know anyone to get a job. Hapa. It's your skill that sells you. That's what I'm saying. So I was saying, uku hakunanga discrimination. You should not be discriminated in terms of race, physique, sex, your beliefs, your religion. Absolutely not. And if anybody discriminates you and you report, that's a problem for that person. Okie dokie, let's go. Sasa hapa. You see, like, the way back home, I used to find, like, tukilipwa end month, tunaenda tunafanya shopping kubwa. Tulikuwa tunasema still monthly shopping. Shopping kubwa. Tunaenda kafo, tunafanya shopping kubwa, tunajua ni monthly shopping. I'm talking even even foodstuffs. Hapa, culture shock is, when I came, I realized, people here shop, like, on a weekly. They have, like, kwanza Saturday. Saturday morning, super wanga zimeja hivi. Super wanga zimeja. Because people here shop on more or less on a weekly basis. They do weekly grocery shopping. Why? Especially for the food stuff. Because why? Food stuff ya hapa, it doesn't really have long shelf life. So ni fresh. Okay, rather. But back home ungenunua mpaka foodstuff zinakusukuma the whole month. But hapa you find ni kila wiki. And then another thing I noticed, fridges huku wanga very small. Huku we don't have those big American fridges. Fridges huku wanga very tiny. Unacheki kama the size of your sink, hapo chini sink, yo dry inakuanga kwa sink, that level, that small. So really, upper people, I realize they shop on a weekly basis, grocery shopping on a weekly basis, because the products that they buy, especially za kukula, food stuff, they don't have long shelf life. So unakula munamaliza, next week munaenda mnanunua zingine munamaliza, like that, you know, like veg, fruit, blah blah blah, maziwa nini hizo. But of course vitu kama toilet paper, vitu kama cleaning products, I mean, that's not what I'm talking about. But what I'm saying is, hapa, hey, kwanza saa tu utakuta watu wamejama super. Na trolleys, kila mtu na trolley. Hey, unalipa ka pound pale kwa gate, ukiingia kwa door, unalipa pound ili natoka, ile trolley natoka. Then, so that you're encouraged to return it, ili you get your pound back, unarudisha trolley so you can get your pound back. Anyway, yeah, weekly grocery shopping hapa niliona, because mostly the food stuff here they don't have long shelf life, and storage fridges wanga small. Of course, there are those guys who've bought chest freezer. Yeah. What else? Let's talk about seasons. So hapa we have four seasons in a week. We have four seasons. By the way, I'll come back to that. Musi cheke kwanza. Tuko Britain, that is possible. Anyway, we have four seasons throughout the year. So we have winter, we have spring, we have summer, and we have fall. So, winter ni ile baridi. Winter inakuanga baridi proper. And sometimes kuna snow, kuna kuna frost. It's very, very cold. And then winter time, the nights are very, very long. Kai. Unaweza kuta giza imeanza 3 a.m. Giza totoro imeanza 3 a.m. Na morning, hiyo giza inaisha huko masaa 2 past. Yeah, that's winter. Now, summertime unakuta the days are very, very long. Unakuta daytime imeendelea all the way mpaka past 10. Jua bado unaiona iko mahali. Like you can see, it looks like dawnish, duskish. Uko 10 p.m. You can walk around without even, you can even drive without putting on your what's it called? Putting on zile lights zako za usiku. Because bado jua iko. Nayo usiku inakuanga very short. Ati senyo naona giza full. I very few hours. By 3 a.m. unaanza kuona sasa kunakaa kama dusk. Kama dawn dusk. You know, like you can see the sun is somewhere. Of course, I wanted the sun, but unaona light. So actually people, when I kanga the darker blinds during summertime, so that light isi kuamushe by 3 a.m., 4 a.m., kunakaa mchana. Anyway, I remember when I tripped and said we can have four seasons in the week. Let me tell you, hapo unaweza kuta mkona four seasons in a day. Britain, the weather is so unpredictable, darlings. Unaweza amka asubuhi uone jua. Assume it's gonna be a warm day. Don't ever leave the house without a jacket. Weka jacket kwa gari. Why? I swear there's a time winter ikikuja kuisha. So tushanza kuingia spring. Hata sasa spring inaisha by the way, because summer should start this month. Officially, summer should start this June. Anywho. So it's my niece who's texted me. So nimeona ka text kame flash. Let me just finish the video, then I'll get back to her. So unakuta, what was I saying? Unakuta asubuhi umeamka, the sun is out. It's nice and warm. Aya, around saa ine, ndio hiyo mvua. So you see, in the morning, the sun was out. So that's what? Summer. Saa ine, ndio hiyo mvua. Hiyo ni spring. Suseme saa nane, ndio hiyo baridi. Baridi, sometimes at us. By the way, there's a time I drove from my house going to a client who's like 20 minutes away. Nilitoka hapa kwangu kukiwa na jua. Kufika hiyo side ya hiyo client, fluffs zilikuwa zinaanguka. They call them flurries. You know, the lighter snow, flurries. Imagine. So hiyo ni snow. Sasa, ndiyo hiyo winter after. Usiku, wind ina blow. Yani unaona tu miti zina dance. That's autumn. So in a day huku unaweza kuta, una experience all the four seasons. That's a culture shock. And then when I was very new, na because me, I came at the peak of summer when vile nilikuja, nilikuwa nashanga, guy, tuko tao, tumeenda sijui Primark, kufanya shopping. Anyway, I'll get to that. No, unasahau ku track time. You forget the track of time, you just lose track of time. Unaangalia clock, uko kwa street, unaona, yo, it's 9:30 p.m. Kuna kaa mchana. And the town is so busy. Guys are going out. Guys are going to eat. And then the beer gardens, sai, during summertime, beer gardens wanga zimefunguliwa. So people like to drink their pints outside the restaurant or the club or the bar. Wanakulia hapo nje, wana enjoy the sun, wana enjoy their meals outside. If there's something I really used to look forward to, ni kukaa nje kwa street, mnakulia hapo nje. You know, mko nje kabisa, viti zimekuwa nje, mko street, mko hapo. Yeah, so anyway, that's I was culture shock nilipata kuona vile summer. The days are so long. Another culture shock. Sema najua we normally wind clocks forward and backward within the year two times. So kama sasa, summertime, clocks uforwardiwa mbele. Because the nights, so that we can have, the nights can be longer. So that the days can be longer, so that we have more time outside. And then during winter, we wind the clock back, both by one hour. We wind the clock back at the end of autumn, so that now we can start, because the nights are longer. Yeah, because the nights start longer. You just wind the clock back. Zinaitangwa daylight saving, you know, so that you maximize on the day, on the light of the day, hours are more, and then I feel like I'm blabbing. daylight saving is when you're trying to maximize the sun, you know, you maximize the outside time because the sun is out and the nights, the days are longer, so you spend more time out. So now gives you an extra hour, if it makes sense. But you can always Google for yourself to get the real details, okay? So right. You guys, mnachikingi vile nyumbani huko. Niliwaambia about social classes being very well defined. Yeah, kasi mimi mnajua ni shags mondo. I'm a Kirinyaga person. Wakenyoni nyaga from Kirinyaga. Sasa simu na cheki vile nyumbani kuna kuanga social classes are very well defined. Like unajua hata ukiangalia tu mtu by face unajua tu we hawa ni wadosi. Mpaka zile nguo amevaa, mpaka vile ka skin kanakaa kako smart moisturized. Unajua tu huyu ni mdosi. Gari zenye wana drive the sections of town people are going, unajua tu hey, hawa ni mababe. Darling, then to kuja sasa huku abroad. Why am I laughing? Because I find it funny. Because back home naonanga, wadosi, watoto wadosi, the cool kids don't quite really mix up with the shags people. I mean, hardly. Unless kama nyinyi ni marela, ama maybe mtu wenu anaendanga huko kuosha, ama mtu wenu anaendanga huko kutengeneza, iya ni fundi, ama... I mean, more or less than not, you will never find those two classes mingling. But wadosi wanaendanga cool places, you know, cool places. They go to cool coffee houses, they go to cool restaurants. Eh? You know what I mean? Yani kunako ka, they don't really mix up with the ordinary. Now, wacha tupande ndege tutoke JK, ndio sisi hao tumefika Heathrow, London. Tumefika hapa. Let me tell you. Yo cool kid inashukianga hapo. Tukiingia Heathrow sisi wote tuko same as up. Mzungu atambui hizo ma cool kid nothing. Hapa tuko same as up. We're from Africa. Oh yeah, I'm from Africa. We are Africans. I'm from Asia. Yes, I'm from Asia. You are Asians. Hakuna maneno na cool kid, what? What is that? Watu Arunda, watu Kirinyaga, same was up. Abroad is a major equalizer, you guys. Kama sayo kiniona huku kwa street, nikichapa kibaru yangu. Utakuta ata cool kid ako huko pia yeye. Buga hawon. Huku hakuna... Mzungu hatambui, you're a cool kid. Hatambui, wewe ni wa Kirinyaga yeshage. They don't tambui with that. Mzungu hatambui. Unless kama uko cool kid level ya kina Davido, where they have private jets in their yard. Iyo maybe wanaweza sema, oh, these are the ones that they're the kings in Africa. You know? Kama coming back to America. I'm a Wakanda for life. Wakanda baby. I'm dying. Mukitoka JKIA, mukifika Heathrow, same was up. Runda meets Kirinyaga. Cooking where? Mzingi hata mbui hizo. Ati wewe ni cool kid. Cool kid. Cool kid where? Ata nimenyongwa. Mingu kuna cool kid amefanya ninyongwa. Cool kid where? Unless kama nyinyi ni nizo level za kina. Like I said, unless muko ile level yenye wananza kuimagine. You know, coming to America, you've watched the movie for Eddie Murphy. Where this prince comes to Africa to look for a bride. So anatembea huko kama hey, kama mtoto wa Mufasa. Nani amesema si funny? Ni funny. Ebu chakeni kwanza na hit like na subscribe. Anyway, mzungu huku hajui hizo vitu. Sijui cool kid, nothing, nothing. Hajui hizo vitu huku. We are all Africans. Period. Apa abroad kuna kuwa equalizing, my dear. Unakuja, unaanza record yako fresh. Kama ni credit score inaanza fresh. Hakuna maneno na cool kid. Unaanza credit score yako kama sisi. Tuko what? Tunaanza kubuild. Bills utalipa, darling. Okay, wewe lipiwa, ni sawa, hakuna shida, but tutalipa. Kibaru utatoanga. Hata nikwambia hapa life can be hard. So hata hawa wanakujanga huku lazima wafanye kazi kama just like the rest of us. Unless mzungu ajue, sidhani. Unless kama mko hiyo level ya kina David wenye mko na private jets in your yard, no, sasa now that can be a cool kid. Unaweza consideriwa, watakumbuka, like, is it like, coming to America, Prince Akeem. Iyo ndio level ya cool kid wanaweza tambua. Eh? Ile baba ya Akeem, alikuanga na nini? Huyo baba ya Akeem alikuwa ameweka pets kama elephants. Alikuanga na elephants in the yard. And then he watched Coming to America. Akeem alikuwa naamushwa na the birds singing, you know. Bird inakuja inaimba ili muamushe. Anapigiwa band. I don't know who used to come with the flute. Anamuamusha gently because he's the prince. Ama, Wakanda. Hakuna maneno na cool kid hapa. Sisi wacha tukosee mozap. Culture shock ni, hakuna hiyo hapa. Izo ma divisions kubwa kubwa hakuna. Na tukikuja huku hakuna maneno. Mzungu atambu hizo ma cool kid. Darling, cool kid wapi? All of us are affording beamers. All of us are affording ODs. All of us now we are using iPhones. All of us we can buy things we want to wear. Kai bibi kwaza wachatu ni seto. Niki seto, I'll buy myself nice thing. Actually, there's a perfume I want to buy myself. Aki na niliweka kwa basket the day I landed in this country. And that's the first thing I'm going to reward myself. Nikisha seto. Thank you, Jesus, for giving me that vision and the hope that I'm going to afford that perfume. You know, like I'm saying, apa, sisi tuko semo zap. Kuna hizo madivisions nyingi, kama nyumbani whereby unaona tu, we, hao ni wadosi wanaenanga tu hizo nice restaurants, hao wanaenanga those cool coffee shops. Oh, this one's only go to those funky churches. We, sisi ni we, hakuna hapa. Abroad, we equalize watu. Vitu zenye ulikuwa umezoea nyumbani kama we ni cool kid, unakuja unakuta hapa, kila mtu ako nazo. You know what I mean? Wewe umelelewa na Range Rovers huko nyumbani, na sisi tumelelewa huko na Futsubishi na Subaru na Lexus, lakini tukikuja huko unakuta hata sisi tunazibai. Like we can actually afford to get those big cars. We can actually afford to get ourselves iPhones. We can actually afford to get ourselves cool shoes, cool perfumes. Aye, we can travel. Eh, huko unakuta sasa watu wakienda holiday, when people are on holiday, and you're sasa wameenda Bahamas, ndio wameenda Hawaii, ndio wameenda, because now sasa huku weekend. Mm? Huku abroad ni kwetu sisi wote. Na hiyo point imenifurahisha, hiyo point nilikuwa nataka kuiongelelea sana. Bugawan. So huku, abroad ni yetu sisi wote. Haijalishi kama wewe ni Mkirinyaga, haijalishi kama wewe ni wa... kama wewe ni wauko Keno, ama wewe ni Warunja, ama ni Karen, kama wewe ni wa Madhare, Tomara, kama wewe ni wa Githurai, kama wewe ni Mazima, ukishafika Heathrow, wewe pia ni cool kid, wewe you're a summer bunny, darling. Summer bunnies drive me crazy. Na kwa hayo machache, I'm gonna drop it there. And it's been nice. Na leo nimewatumia video ya 50 minutes. You know, 50 minutes nimejaribu sana. I hope you enjoy the culture shock. Nikikumbuka ingine ndakuja. But now, I owe some people a video. I owe some ladies and gentlemen a video on the gynecological test I was done for last year. Nilikumbuka nilikuwa nimewapromise kuambia about that. excuse me. So now the next video ndafanya, I'll do about that. You know, I told you, like, I'll tell you something about the tests I was done for. The test I was done for last year, and it was a bit different. And ilikuwa imenifanya niende. Ilikuwa imeniaffect kiasi because it was very new to me. And then I learned, I can educate guys so that now when you go uko nyumbani ukienda kwa gaina wako, muna have some conversations. I mean, we learn every day, don't we? So I'll do that video next time. And it's been wee! Mwah!